Already got Margaret's husband. Gee.
There you go.
Did you want one?
Sorry.
Red wine, white wine?
Oh, white wine?
I've never bartended before, so. Yeah, well, good thing I don't have to mix.
Just introduce yourself, yeah.
Oh, I'm Margaret Ezekiel. I'm standing in the middle of my field.
All right.
Hi, I'm in the world. And we are so lucky on the way to that from the dedicated to fine art. And I do hope and pray that she settles in over there to keep in business. So we're going to begin here this evening with our blessing on all of this work and on this gallery and on Luna and on Margaret and on Rosa. Rosa, come up here to see. And I'm going to begin by asking Margaret to tell us a little something about this work that seems to be able to step out of the frame. This man here. He could be standing there himself.
Oh, make the shut up, boy!
You did that!
Yeah.
But Margaret, could you please say something about him?
I don't know how to push him.
You know, it's unfair of me to ask an artist to talk about their work when their work speaks for themselves. Their work speaks for them. How do you do it?
I don't know.
So let me ask you some questions. How long have you known that this is what you should do?
Louder, Margaret, louder.
Okay. My first set of crayons were made from mini wax, and my studio was under the dining room table. Because I sit under the dining room table, and that's how my mom gets to do that. We got everybody else in the house. And it's just stuff.
So if it weren't for those beeswax crayons, you'd be meddling in everyone else's affairs. And oil paint, and as a result of the beeswax crayons,
it changed my life.
Emphasized integrity. He didn't care if it was a large
but it has to have integrity. Ooh, I love that.
Yeah. And he caught you on it.
This is Rosa's womb. Feasting.
It's called We Appear at the Source, and the Source is Kauai. So this is about my last 10 years of living on Kauai and how it affects me as a person. And so that's why the beginning starts with the mind of the effects of place. And mind the subject, so the changes of in the subject. So it's kind of like I'm a scientist before I'm wearing my scientific jacket. I'm observing myself. And so I'm noting what has happened to myself by living on Hawaii in the last 10 years. And is this stuff from the place that is only about Hawaii? Or would it have happened to me somewhere else? I don't know. But there's all these conclusions of all these things that have happened to me since I've come to Hawaii. And like I talk about on here that, you know, I've discovered NBC and I've discovered methods like don't be attached to outcomes. And then it's led to increased coincidences in my life and miracles have happened to me. And I'm not living in obligation anymore. And I have a lot more trust. And that was the desired result for me in my life, to have a lot more trust. And that's part of it. And then also, like being an artist, the blue line is about the fact that on Hawaii I realized that I'm only seeing blue lines. If it's the sky or the ocean, every day there's a blue line. And to me, my favorite thing about Hawaii is probably the sky. That I constantly, almost every day, look up and it's just like magic. And so that was the original intention with the blue. And then these have all been painted on the wall and then washed away because they're a memory. Because this is from my show at the biennial, where what I wanted to do in Oahu was bring Hawaii to Oahu, the magic of Hawaii, and try to show it on Oahu. And I had it as this one continuous line of the experiences that I've had and all the things that I've learned. And then bringing it back to Hawaii, how would I show that here? Well, I wouldn't want to show that because everybody that lives here, I feel like they know. They have this intrinsic knowing about the magic of this place and the power. And that's why, to me, we're standing on the power source right now, and that's why it's shooting these lines up and creating this sort of warping of reality, in a way, by this place. And these are sort of like the waves in the ocean, and so what I did was I made, it was like a graph, but the graph is warped by Hawaii and by the experience of Hawaii. And this is kind of like the next step for me was the sort of like the vortex of the past 10 years and all that these slight moments have been of a sort of like a healing for me, and that's why there's bottles that are like different medicine bottles, and just moments that have been real medicine for me. Like one time just looking at the raindrops on a leaf, and the other time I remember I was feeling really in my head and just having just one of those days where I couldn't really feel like I was here, and all of a sudden I picked up a shell, a Kukui shell, and I was just in total amazement that that was a natural creation. And so perfect, so in alignment. And so that's what that one is. And watching the nesting albatross near my house and watching them go back and forth with the egg and protecting the egg. And then the blue lines are also about all the machines and all the workings of life that we don't always think about that are happening, like our hearts are pumping and all that's going on in our bodies and all the life and all that's happening right now to make this moment happen. And so that's what a lot of the blue lines are about as well. And they're also sort of like this blueprints, and they're actual machines that I've manipulated a little bit because like of the meaning of them, like this one's a power generator, and I manipulate a little bit, and then it's generating. And then the wood is cut from our land, which my husband's right there taking pictures. We grew these plants from seed and then nourished them and fertilized them. And then to me, it's like that has such a connection working with life force and creating children. And that has been so much of my experience of the last 10 years. So powerful, like compared to just making art, but working with life force. And so that's the, you know, and then I've